In this screencast, we're going to go through an example of simulating a fermentation using the SuperPro Designer software. Now, this problem gives you a number of pieces of information that would help you with a simulation setting up a fermentation. First and foremost, it tells you what the stoichiometry of the fermentation reaction is, and you can see that here in the middle. And then we get certain information about the feed and exit streams. The rest of this problem can be seen below, in which we're given temperature data as well as some enthalpy data that we're going to use. The main question is that we want to determine the amount of time required to completely consume the reaction components and determine what the rate limiting reactant is for this system. So to do this, we're going to use SuperPro Designer. Now when you start SuperPro Designer, you'll get to a screen that asks you whether or not you want to open a new process or start a new one. So click on the Start a New Process and click OK. It will then ask you whether or not you want to do batch or continuous operations. Since this is a batch fermentation, we're going to make sure that batch is clicked and then click OK. So this brings us to our main screen, which becomes our process flow diagram. Now I'm going to do two things. Since we're working with just a specific section, I'm going to rename that section, which you could do here. And I'm going to call it fermentation. So if we were doing a large process where we had multiple different steps of that process, including separations, we could label each of those sections so that when we do our cost analysis, we could focus in on these areas. Now, branches can also be used if you have side reactions that you're working on or other problems that come into that main branch. And so I will rename this branch Fermentation Reactor. Hopefully you could reference the document that is linked next to this video so that you can figure out which species we need to add. And that's the first thing we need to do, is identify the components that we're going to use for this reactor and this system. So we go to Tasks, and we could go to Pure Components and Register Edit View Properties. At this point, we want to make sure that we add all of the things involved in the reaction. So as you saw before, we need to add biomass. We need to add MAB, a monoclonal antibody. We also need to add air and media. And so I'm going to start going through those and how to add that. So let's first add biomass. You can either search for it in this box or scroll down and find it in our list. So you can see we have biomass right here. Now we click on the register button to add it to our list. Now I'm going to do this for carbon dioxide as well as sodium chloride. Now you see that an error message came up saying that we don't have all the physical properties needed. However, we don't need a heat of vaporization for this reaction. So we'll just click OK and know that it's not in the database of properties. Now let's say I added the wrong chemical by accident. I added sodium chlorate. We could always click on this X up here to remove it. Now there are a couple components listed in the problem statement that aren't in this list. So we add a new component by clicking on this wand icon up in the top right corner. So here we could add whatever we would like. So I'll type in an impurity, since that was one of the things listed, and not have to worry about all the other things. Hit OK. Then I'll also add media and MAB. Now that you have all your components added to this problem, we could click on OK. Now we need to add our fermenter. So we could go up to Unit Procedures, and we're working with a batch vessel, specifically a fermenter. You'll see an icon that says Add Step. So you click anywhere on your screen, and we now have our fermenter. So you can see what streams we have entering and exiting our fermenter. So we need to label those streams and create them in our simulation. So to create streams, we're going to go up to this icon next to the arrow that says Connect Mode. We'll click anywhere here on our chart and then click again at an inlet to our fermenter. So we'll do this for our five streams. So we have our five streams, but we'd like to change the name so that they match what we had in our problem statement. So to do that, go back to our arrow icon and click on the stream. Right-clicking will bring up some options, whereas we can then choose Edit Tag Name. So for this one, we want to enter in water. We can then change this to media and so forth. So we want to identify the streams and make sure that the right components are in them. So if we double-click on the water stream now, it will bring up the following menu. We could choose which one of our components make up that composition. And since this is all water, clicking on water and dragging it into the field here allows us to choose what the conditions are for this stream. So clicking on ingredient flows allows us to change this value to 7800 kilograms per batch, since that was the problem statement. We can then make sure that the temperature down here and the pressure are correct. So we click on OK, and now we've labeled that water stream with the correct component. I'll do the same thing for the media stream. This time, we want to make sure that we have our biomass as well as our media as the two components that make up this stream. We could click again on ingredient flows and set our media stream to 5 kilograms per batch biomass and 375 kilograms per batch of media. Again, the temperature is 25 degrees and the pressure is 1.013 bar. Click OK. Now when we open up the airstream, one of the things we could do with the airstream is click on stock mixtures. And you can add stock mixtures to your workbooks as you go forth and do this, but air is one that is standard with SuperPro. Clicking on it will allow us to change the composition of the air, but since it's a stock mixture, we really want it to automatically adjust what's necessary based on our reaction. So we can click on this auto adjust down below. So depending on the stoichiometry, it will determine how much air we need to add to our system. So the next and last thing that we really do is set the fermenter up by adding operations. So if you right click on the fermenter, click on the add remove operations, there's a whole list of operations we can control for this fermenter. So this process will require two charges, one for media, so we'll add a charge, another one for water. We're also going to need to heat it to its fermentation temperature. So click on heat, add that. We could then add kinetic fermentation, a cooling phase, and then transferring everything out of the fermenter. Now you see that this isn't quite the operation sequence we want. So we need to make sure that we put things in the right order. So we're going to charge, then we're going to heat, we're going to ferment, cool, and then transfer. So once we have these set up in the right order, we can click OK. And now we have to set them up. So again, right click on the fermenter. Now we go to operation data and start with the first charge. So it brings you a couple of tabs that are important in determining how you want to set up this reaction. So first and foremost, we're going to charge with the water stream, and we're going to make sure that it imported the right amount of flow, which is 7800 kilograms. And now we could determine other conditions. So for the setup time, let's use 5 minutes. We'll use a volumetric flow rate as 100 liters per minute. Since this is all we want to determine with this charge, we can then click on this tab at the bottom, which says, OK, next operation. It will take us to our charge for the other stream. This one we're going to click media. Again, we have a mass of 380 kilograms. This time we're going to have a setup time of 20 minutes and a mass flow rate of 10 kilograms per minute. We can click the next operation to move on. This brings us to our heating operation. Now for most fermenters, and in this problem statement, the fermentation takes place at 37 degrees. So we'll put 37 degrees here as the final temperature, and we'll set the rate of heating as 0.5 degrees Celsius per minute. There's no other things that we need to set up necessarily to do this material energy balance problem. As you can see, there are a number of options in terms of changing the utility used, as well as adding in information on the heat transfer rate. That's something that you would determine on your own before simulating. Now the fermentation is the one complicated aspect of this process, since that's what we're focusing on. It should take the most amount of effort. So the final temperature is 37 degrees. We're going to say that there's no setup time, a 24-hour reaction time, and a specific power of 3 kilowatts per meter cubed in terms of using it for agitation mixing. These are all default values that appeared when we opened up the fermentation operation. Now we can click on the volume tab and say that the maximum allowable volume is 90%. If we click on reactions, we need to set up our stoichiometric reaction. So we go over here to this flask looking icon, and it brings up a table where we import our reactants and our products. So clicking on this, we can bring in our reactant. We know we have media and oxygen that react to form more biomass. Obviously we need biomass in the first place, but we don't add that as a reactant. Carbon dioxide also forms some of what we said was an impurity, monoclonal antibody, and water. So it's important at this point to make sure that we have our mass coefficient icon clicked on, and then we're going to fill in the proper values for this. So I'm just going through the problem statement and doing this for our reactants and our products. You should have the following values, and I'll click on OK. Now we are told that this reaction does have an enthalpy of reaction associated with it. So we're going to unclick the ignore, and we're going to make sure that we type in the correct enthalpy, which is 3,697 kilocals per kilogram, and it's negative. The reference temperature, or reference component, is oxygen, and it's referenced at 37 degrees, since that's our fermentation temperature. Now we need to click on the reaction scheme box up here to enter in kinetic information related to this fermentation. So starting on the left, we're going to click media as our substrate and make sure that Monode kinetics are applied. We're given that it has a K sub S is 35 milligrams per liter. The reference component up here is our biomass, and we're going to use a mu max value of 0.2 hours inverse. For the biomass, we could click here and make sure that we select the correct biomass, and that's first order. Click OK. Now we're almost done with our fermenter. We go up to vent and emissions and make sure that we have the proper components coming out of the vent. So we're going to check the emissions box, click on the emitted for carbon dioxide, and then we want to set it to a specific value, and since this is the only thing coming out of the vent, we'll make it 100%. We don't have a condenser at this point attached to our fermenter, so we'll turn that off. And then we want specific data collected for this fermenter, so we go to profiles. We want to know what the biomass over time looks like, as well as the monoclonal antibody production and the media usage. So we check those three boxes. This will collect data for us during the simulation, which we can then open in Excel and plot. At this time, we have everything entered that we want. We could click OK. And the only last process that we have to set up is the cool and the transfer. So clicking on cool will bring us to the cool operation. Now we want a final temperature of 5 degrees. And we want to use a different utility, since chilled water won't get us there very efficiently. So double-clicking on glycol will bring up glycol as our utility. Then we can again set our cooling rate, so we'll use the same cooling rate as heating rate as the 0.5 degrees Celsius per minute. Clicking on the next tab will bring us to our last operation for our transferring out. For this operation, we're going to make sure that 100% of the vessel contents get emptied out with no setup time. We're going to set the time for this transfer as 272 minutes. Clicking OK shows us that we have an error. We need to select a valid stream for our port. So just like we did before with some of the streams, we want to select down and go to broth to say that that's how we are going to transfer everything out through that stream that we labeled before. Now we have our process fully developed. At this point, it's probably a good idea to save your work. But we want to solve the material and energy balances, so this calculator icon up in the middle here will do that. So clicking on it shows us that we performed the M&E balances successfully. And we could click on the vent and broth streams to look at the flow rates of each of the components. So it's done our material and energy balances for us. You could also look at the broth and see what the flow rates for the biomass and our products will be. Since we are interested in the composition results with time, we could right-click on the fermenter, go to Dynamic Data Records, and save it in an Excel formatted file. Click Yes, and it will give us the option of saving our data. Opening this data and plotting it, and we changed our secondary axis so that we could better view the monoclonal antibody production over time. You could see that our media gets to a value of 0 right around 16 hours, which shows us that that is our limiting reactant in this reaction. Now if we right-click on the fermenter, we could also click on procedure data, and that shows us that we have a batch fermentation cycle that requires 32 hours for this part of the process. Lastly, we could go to reports and click on material and streams, and we'll generate a report if we've saved it. Now we've generated our full report for this process, which gives us an idea of the operating time, materials that we're using, gives us physical properties of the streams as well as composition. Shows us the time for each part of the process, all the operations that we used. And all this would be very important, especially with a large process in which this is just one operation. And one last trick to show you is that because we've set this up as a section, the fermentation section, we can go to Edit Section Properties, and we could change the color of this area by clicking on the following. So say we wanted to label all this as red. Hopefully this gives you a good idea on how to run some parts of SuperPro, especially with setting up a fermentation.